The IRR function calculates the internal rate of return of a series of cash flows. In this example, we have a series of cash flows starting with an initial investment, a negative number in period zero, and then a whole bunch of cash inflows over the next 5 years. We'd like to work out what the internal rate of return of these cash flows are. If we click in the cell where we want the result and activate the function wizard, we can go to the financial category, go to IRR, and when we say OK, we are asked for these arguments. The first one is the values, which is basically an array or reference to cells that contain the numbers for which we want to calculate the IRR. So in that case, it would be this list here. And then you're asked for a guess. And in some cases, the IRR cannot come up with a number. You need to put in a guess. And generally, I put in 0.1 or 10%. And when you click OK, you'll see the IRR is calculated. In order for the IRR to work, you need to understand two issues. The first is that your series of cash flows must contain at least one negative number and at least one positive number in order for it to work. Otherwise, it'll deliver an error message. The second issue is that unlike the NPV function, the IRR function assumes that the first value it is given occurs in period zero, and after that, it goes to period 1, 2, whereas the NPV function assumes that the first number it's given occurs at the end of period one. This is extremely important, especially if you're trying to reconcile your NPVs to your IRR numbers.